Hi, my name is Robert Feranek. I'm from FEDEVEL Academy, and in this video we are going to speak about a small but useful tip. We are going to speak about different ways of selection in Altium Designer. And I need to tell you, even I didn't know about this for a very long time, sometimes it was, because I didn't know about this, sometimes I tried to follow some YouTube videos, and because I use different kind of selection method, then my board was not behaving exactly same way as it was shown in the video. And I was like, oh, why it doesn't work? They show in there, it looks like it works there, why it doesn't work in my board same way? And it was because of this. Have a look. This versus this. And now you know what we are going to talk about. Basically, if you press left button on your mouse, hold it down, and when you try to draw this selection rectangle from this top left corner, and when you finish drawing this selection rectangle down here in bottom right corner, so release the left button, then it is different comparing to drawing this selection rectangle from this top right corner to this bottom left corner. And the difference is that when you use this method, when you use this blue rectangle, then only the components or the objects which are completely inside of this blue rectangle are going to be selected. If you use this green rectangle, then all the objects, not only the objects which are completely inside, but also the objects which are partially inside of this green rectangle are going to be selected. Okay, so if I draw this blue rectangle here, what is going to be selected? These two tracks which are here, okay? However, if I draw exactly same rectangle, but this way, what is going to be selected? Not only these two tracks, but also this one, and also this one, yeah? So, okay? And same way, you can select objects also in the schematic. So if I go into schematic, let's say we would like to select these two capacitors. So this way, nothing is going to be selected. This way, the capacitors are going to be selected. If we would like to use this way, we need to select the capacitors completely. But if we use exactly same selection rectangle but draw it this way, then not only the capacitors will be selected, but also some of the wires will be selected. Okay, this here. And because we are speaking about this selection, some time ago I made a video also about how to select tracks, but I know many people, they still don't know this trick. So very often, if you need to select the whole track, which is on one layer, then select one segment of the track, and press tab on your keyboard. Watch what is going to happen. So press tab. Yeah. Then the track which you selected will be select, or the track which is connected to this selected segment is going to be selected on same layer. Okay. If you would like to select the track completely on all the layers, then press tab again. Now also the part of the track which is routed on different layers is selected. Okay, so one more time. If you need to select a track on one layer, then select one segment of the track, press tab once. And if you would like to select the complete net, also all the tracks which are connected to the same net, then press tab again. Like this. Very, very useful. By the way, this layout, what you can see here, it is a layout from our open source board. It's called OpenRex. And if you like, you can go or you can Google for this IMX6Rex. Go on our website, and if you like, you can completely download the Altium files and all the manufacturing files of this project, and you can play with the files. You can play with the, or you can have a look on the PCB layout, you can have a look on the schematic. We have more open source projects. If you go on the main website of this IMX6Rex, you can find there also different boards. This one is also very interesting. Many people have a look on the layout of this module, which is here. Okay, that's everything for today's video. I really hope you found it useful. If yes, please don't forget press like button. And thank you very much for watching. See you next time. Bye.